Hey, Garland Vance here. In 1967, the futurist Hermann Kahn predicted that by the year 2000, the average person would need to work only 30 hours per week and have 13 weeks of vacation due to increases in technology and wages. Has that been your experience? I hope so, but I've met very few people who only work 30 hours a week and are taking 13 weeks of vacation every year. A few years ago, when I started realizing how busy I was and how busy everybody was and that it was killing all of us, I was working 50 to 60 hours per week. I was given a generous 3 weeks of vacation with my organization, but after 10 years, I got 4 weeks. I had 3 young kids at home, traveled 60 days every year for work, was helping our church, and had started a doctoral program. I was stressed, exhausted, and overwhelmed. And the research shows that this stress, exhaustion, and overwhelm are what most people are experiencing today. Let me give you some facts. First fact, according to the U.S. Travel Association, the average number of vacation days has dropped from 21 days per year in 2000 to 16 days in 2013. At the same time, the number of hours that people work has gone up. According to a Gallup survey in August 2014, adults who are employed full-time work an average of 47 hours per week. That's a full workday almost, longer than what a standard 9-to-5 schedule entails. In fact, half of all full-time workers indicate that they typically work more than 40 hours, and 4 in 10 say they work more than 50 hours. A Putman study from 2000 indicates that the number of people who always feel rushed increased 50% between 1960 and 1990. And that was way back in 1990. Has your pace of life increased since then? In 2005, the National Institute for Occupational Safety and Health found that 40% of all workers today feel overworked, pressured, and squeezed to the point of anxiety, depression, and disease. Last fact, in Japan, death by overworking has become so prevalent that they have a term for it, karoshi. Recent statistic reports that almost 1,500 Japanese workers have died from karoshi. And there's even a Secretary General of the National Defense Council for Victims of Karoshi. His name is Hiroshi Kawahito, and he believes that the actual figures of karoshi could be 10 times higher. Now, does any of this feel familiar to you? The stress, the exhaustion, the overwhelm? But it doesn't have to be this way. Too many of us think that busyness, that stress, overwhelm, and exhaustion are normal, that we are supposed to feel this way. But there's another way, and there's a better way. In fact, I work less hours than I've ever worked. I take more vacation time than I've ever taken. I sleep more than I've ever slept, and I get more done than I've ever gotten before. And it's because I got unbusy. And you can get unbusy too. You can stress less, accomplish more, and enjoy your life. Now, it takes 5 steps to beat busyness. So you can discover how busy you are by going to gettingunbusybook.com. You can take an assessment there to find out how busy you are, or you can download the first 6 chapters of Getting Unbusy for free. And I'll share with you in those chapters the 5 steps that you need to take to kill busyness so that you can live and lead with purpose, productivity, and peace.